in the process, made a little inked puddle or two. Hey everybody. This pen has been sitting for weeks. It's made by Platinum, very inexpensive pen. I was just trying to get it to write again. It was dry. And in the process, made a little inked puddle or two. Soaked it up really nicely. Here's the Jinhao. X570 Shimmering Sands. No, it's an X750, I think. Yeah. It's an X750. It's been sitting the same amount of time. And it will not write. Let's see if we can coax it. I had to make a piston move down to force some ink into the feed and thus into the nib. Once this pen gets going, it's very pleasant to write with. Got a stub nib, 1.5 millimeters, a nice wide downstroke, and a thin side stroke. It's not a flex nib. But what you end up with kind of reminds you of one. And another pen that I've had laying around inked up was this Pilot Vanishing Point. It's kind of an unusual pen. I'll zoom out just a little bit. This pen has a button, kind of like a ballpoint pen does. And when you push it, the nib extends out of a little trap door type deal. This is a stub nib. I think it's 1 millimeter. Zoom in. So the stub nib, it's not as wide as the Jinhao 1.5, but it still has a nice wide downstroke and a thin side stroke. This paper is just an inexpensive legal pad. It's not necessarily fountain pen friendly, I don't think, but it's doing okay. so I'm pleased. That it seems to write well after sitting for weeks. What else do I have that's been sitting around the same amount of time? Here's a pilot falcon. The falcon has a real interesting shape of the nib. It reminds you of the beak of a falcon, I guess. And it too writes without hesitation after sitting for weeks. The nib on this one is a medium. Let's take a look. SM, that's soft medium. The nib on this is, it says soft, it's supposed to be somewhat flexible. So without pushing very hard, that's how wide the downstroke is. But you can push on it, flex it just a little bit, and get a little bit of line variation. Nice to see that it can sit for weeks and still write when you pick it up. Some fountain pens are notorious for drying out a little bit during that time. Here's a platinum plissier. Oh, it's not inked. But this pen, you can ink it and leave it laying around for months and months and months and pick it up and write immediately without having to prime it and get it ready. I had it out because I was comparing it with this other platinum. Platinum is a Japanese company, I think. And I forgot what model of platinum this is. I purchased it because it was relatively inexpensive and I love, let me zoom out a little bit. I love the platinum plissier so much because, like I mentioned, it does write when you pick it up. It doesn't seem to dry out. And I was hoping this other model would be similar. But as you can see, it took a little bit of coaxing to get it right. And though it's inexpensive, it's not a bad looking pen. I like the color and I like the gold accents. I do need to take the sticker off of it. And the materials have kind of a inexpensive feel to them, but I forgot what I paid for this. I would have to look. I'll put it in the description. So that's what I've been doing for the past few minutes. I kind of felt like testing these pens. And though I have a fair collection of fountain pens, fountain pen users generally do not have all of their pens inked at one time unless they only own a handful. But generally you ink them and you use them and then you take them out of the rotation. Clean them up, put them away. And these are the four that I have in rotation at the moment. Now the other day I noticed that my wife had left on the kitchen counter this pen here. It's a INC. I guess that's ink precision. This is a 0.7 millimeter. And I picked it up. I did some writing with it. Actually, this is a 0.5. But I thought, well, it's not too bad. She said she got a pack of two for like a dollar at a dollar store. Yeah, new precision tip. It's a roller ball, 0.5 millimeters. So I was thinking that's not bad for a 50-cent pen. So I came home one day and she had left me a little gift. She had left me a pack of these, also made by Ink This is a R2. It's 0.7. And the wind is really howling outside right now. It's got a nice precision feel to it. Not really sure how good a pen it is or how long it might last. But one thing I do notice is inside the cap there appears to be a rubber seal that when you push the tip of the pen in, it just kind of seals off. Perhaps it keeps it from drying out. And she had also purchased a pack of these foray roller balls. This one is a 0.7. And it too has a what appears to be some kind of a rubber seal up inside. And I believe she said this was like $1 for a pack of two. So it's not a bad deal. Just because I prefer to write with fountain pens doesn't mean that I can't appreciate the writing qualities of a much more inexpensive pen. I don't get quite the feedback while writing that I would with a fountain pen. But these are still fun to write with. So sat down to do a video, my intentions were to do a catalog video, but I couldn't keep my eyes off of the fountain pens. And I kept wondering if they would write after sitting for so long. And one thing led to another, so I decided to fire up the camera and begin to shoot this video. As you could tell by the existing writing and ink splotches all over the paper when the video came on. And this is the catalog that I was gonna take a look at and do a this or that type video. But there's some kids next door making all sorts of racket, so we shall come back to this in the next video. You're probably asleep by now anyhow. Thanks for watching.